Hey guys, my name's Sam and welcome to Prep Medic. In this week's video, we are talking about first aid for snake bites. Right now in Colorado, it is snake bite season and we have seen quite a few snake bite injuries over the past couple weeks. Unfortunately, snake bites are one of those things that have a lot of wives' tales surrounding the first aid and treatment of them. And I really want to give you guys a little bit more insight in what to do if you or somebody close to you is bitten by a venomous snake. This particular video will focus mainly on the rattlesnake. However, the principles and concepts I'm going to cover work for any species of snake across the US. Rattlesnake venom predominantly affects the blood and will promote internal bleeding. That being said, only the very old and the very young are at an increased risk of actually dying from a rattlesnake bite. In the US, we only have about 4 to 5 deaths per year from venomous snake bites. If you or someone around you are bit, the first thing you need to do is remove yourself from the vicinity of the snake. They will strike again if they are threatened. You should not try to capture the snake to identify it. However, if you are able to get a picture safely, you should do so to help the hospital better identify that snake and the treatment you need to receive. If you are only able to get a good look at the snake, take a look at the shape of its head and look for any definitive markings on its back. Those will be the biggest indicators of what kind of snake you're dealing with. The next thing you should do is expose and visualize the site of the bite. If you have 2 puncture wounds, that is most likely a viper of some kind, as those are markings from its fangs. That will envenomate somebody. If it looks like a half moon above and below, that is most likely not a venomous snake. Coral snakes can leave the same marking, but their bites are actually very rare and they even more rarely envenomate somebody. Once you visualize the wound, you need to control the bleeding. This is usually best accomplished by a pressure dressing over the wound itself. There is an old wives' tale that you are supposed to take a tourniquet and put it above the wound to keep the venom from spreading. This is completely false. If you need to apply a tourniquet to control life-threatening bleeding, you can do so, but a tourniquet should not be applied routinely to simply stop the venom from getting into the systemic circulation. First of all, this is completely ineffective, and second of all, that venom is very necrotizing and you can actually cause a lot of limb damage by doing so. It's really important through this entire process to keep the victim as calm as possible and to keep their heart rate down. The lower their heart rate is, the less venom will be circulated throughout the body and the longer they'll have to receive treatment. The next step can be to splint the extremity that's affected. If it's the arm, just taking a SAM splint or a stick and just wrapping that around the arm to keep it still will go a long ways to keeping the venom from spreading to the rest of the body. This is not something that's 100% necessary, but if you have the supplies to do so, I'd highly recommend splinting. You should not under any circumstances try to cut the wound or suck on the wound to get the venom out. Both of these risk secondary envenomations and risk increased tissue damage. REI and some other large outdoor stores sell snake bite kits that have suction cups on them to try to get that venom out. However, these are a complete waste of money. They do not work, so I would never advise buying any of them. One of the most important steps in first aid for somebody that's been bitten by a venomous snake is to call 911. While you can oftentimes transport them to the hospital, by calling 911, you can get additional resources for you. In our territory, when somebody calls 911 complaining of a snake bite that's outside of city limits, they actually send a helicopter and an ambulance. The helicopter will carry antivenin on board so they can start that treatment right at the patient instead of waiting a long period of time to get to the hospital. Additionally, antivenin is relatively rare and is not stocked at every hospital, so EMS systems will know exactly where to take you instead of taking you to a hospital that doesn't have it and requiring a transfer. A little known fact about rattlesnakes is only a small percentage of bites will actually have venom in them. A lot of times a rattlesnake will choose to bite but not inject anything because it is very hard to produce that venom internally. The younger the snake is, the more likely they are to envenomate you as they don't have control over the release of that venom as adult snakes do. As you're waiting for the helicopter or EMS units to arrive, you should take a Sharpie and mark the swelling around the wound. Put a timestamp on it right next to it, and then as time goes on, continue to mark it so that people can see the progression of that reaction. You should also be monitoring your patient for signs of envenomation, so those include nausea, vomiting, hypotension, increased bleeding at the site, and a headache. There are any number of other symptoms from different kinds of venoms, and everybody will present slightly differently, but these are kind of the mainstays. Another very real possibility in the chance of envenomation is an anaphylactic reaction. So if somebody is starting to experience signs of anaphylactic shock, they have increased swelling, their throat starts closing, they have really low blood pressures, hives all over their body, you should start treating them for that anaphylactic reaction with epinephrine if they have it on them. Make sure you're passing along any additional information on the patient to the EMS providers when they arrive on scene. As a quick recap, the best things you can do for a patient with a snake bite are to call 911, wrap the extremity, splint the extremity, keep them calm, and mark the areas where the swelling is taking place. If you guys have any questions, please leave them in the comments down below, and I will see you next week.